general, many things affect this wage distribution and as well as this gender pay gap. So one possibility is that the changes in labor demand. So for example, like, you know, this one popular story is the unbiased technological change, which is a shift in production technology which favors skilled workers over unskilled workers by increasing its relative productivity and therefore its relative demand. The other popular story is the effect of free trade, this free trade has negative effects on, you know, the employment and wages of unskilled workers. So some studies argue that free trade may contribute to expanding the gap between wages of skilled workers and unskilled workers. So the other possibility is related to a change in labor supply. So like, for example, like, you know, this, as people's life expectancy has increased significantly, many retired people re-enter the labor market, but unfortunately, they work in, you know, these unskilled labor jobs mostly. So this increase in, so expansion in participation of labor supply by these older people also contributes to expanding the wage gap between workers between unskilled workers and skilled workers. Finally, the labor market institutions can also affect wage distribution. In particular, a change in minimum wage can reduce wage inequalities via two channels. One is, you know, this spike effect, and the other is a spillover effect. The spike effect means that the people who are earning below the minimum wage will go to the new minimum wage. So the other one is that the spillover effect. So spillover effect means that an increase in minimum wage will induce increases in other wages which are greater than this minimum wage. First of all, you know, the issues about the gender pay gap is always important. So, I mean, suppose you are working the same kind of job, but suppose you get a less amount of money because you are a woman, this is not fair. So, and I think it's great opportunity that the APEC associations, now the APEC member economies, are interested in, you know, this investigating these gender issues. This issue is important. For example, this is regardless of development levels, the gender pay gap, the issue of gender pay gap is everywhere. So, I mean, this is a common topic that all the countries should take, and they are actually trying to take into account, and they have been taking into account, you know, these issues. So, I mean, this is the most common issue that all the APEC member economies agreed to discuss and agreed to get some new proposals for the future, yeah, I think. Here, what I'm saying is that the meaning of gender pay gap is that if you have different productivity, you will get different wages. This is the common sense. But what I'm saying here, the gender pay gap, is that even if you are working in the same task, you will get different wages, so this is not good. So that's what I'm trying to say. And for this, I mean, every countries and every, you know, these international organizations should, you know, take into consideration about this issue, yeah.